Imagine the immeasurable vastness of creation, and that this vastness could be captured and measured. Imagine then capturing these creation proportions and putting them into music. That is what Bach did. What effect do these creational proportions have upon the music that we know to be Bach's? And why did he do it? What did it mean to him? These proportions that Bach put into his music cannot be heard. They are not measured by the clock, they are measured by the bar. Why should such a great performer as Johann Sebastian Bach, interested in beauty, put non-sounding proportions into his music? We have a clue in the treatises of the time. There's a motto that they said very many times: the closer to the unity, or the one-to-one proportion, the more perfect, and vice versa. The further away from this one-to-one unison or unity, the more imperfect. This led to the ideals that the one-to-one unity was in fact perfect, and it was indeed beautiful. It goes back to the Greeks, who had a similar philosophy, but when it came to Bach's time, it had been enmeshed with the theology of Lutheran beliefs at the time. There's nothing approximate about the numbers. We find them at the macro level, for example, in the violin works, the six solos for violin and the six sonatas for violin and harpsichord. 2,400 bars in six solos, 2,400 bars in six sonatas, a double one-to-one proportion at the very largest level. Within these 2,400 bars, we have two double two-to-one proportions, 1,600 and 800 bars in four and two solos. Likewise, 1,600 bars and 800 bars in four and two sonatas. These layers and levels of parallel proportions continue throughout the work. In the book, there is demonstrations of these parallel proportions in all of Bach's fair copies and in all of his published collections. Bach and his contemporaries saw these one-to-one and one-to-two proportions as the most beautiful, the most perfect, and thereby as the most glorifying to God.